Dear children, I welcome you all. In this video, I am going to start the first chapter from biozoology. What is the meaning for biozoology? It is a branch of science which deals with the study of animals. The chapter name is The Living World. Children, now I am going to explain diversity in the living world. You already know that the earth has numerous habitats with a wide range of living organisms inhabiting them. The habitat means place of living. Here I am showing different kinds of habitat. Land habitats are otherwise known as terrestrial habitat. Water habitats are otherwise known as aquatic habitat. Forest is an example for terrestrial habitat. Sea is an example for aquatic habitat. So there are variety of species that have been adapted successfully to live in diverse ecosystem. That is, you can see the species, many number of species in polar region, even though it is very cold. The animals have that kind of adaptation to survive in cold region. In hot springs, in Tamil, Vennir Ootru. In hot spring also, few species can live, like bacteria. From tropical rainforest to dry place called the desert. In desert also, so many organisms can able to survive. According to that, they have some adaptation. Children, now I am going to explain about ecosystem. Ecosystem is a community of biotic and abiotic factors and their interrelationships. Actually, it was introduced by A.G. Tansley in the year 1935. So, biotic factors refers only the living things. It includes producers, consumers and decomposers. Producers are plants. All the green plants are producers because they provide the food for other organisms. Consumers. Consumers are animals. It may be herbivores, carnivores. Decomposers are microorganisms. It includes bacteria and fungi because it decomposes the dead and decay matter. Here, I am showing in this slide the example of forest ecosystem and aquatic ecosystem, otherwise sea ecosystem. Here, you can see abiotic factors as well as biotic factors. If there is no sunlight, imagine children, how the plants can able to prepare their own food? It is impossible. So, the animals also can't survive. So, we need oxygen to live. So it is the community of biotic and abiotic factors under interrelationships. And then biodiversity. The presence of large number of species in a particular ecosystem is called a biological diversity or in short biodiversity. The term biodiversity was first introduced by Walter Rosen in the year 1985 and defined by E.D. Wilson. The same explanation only, children, because the large number of species in a particular forest ecosystem and particular sea ecosystem. Characteristic features of living organisms. The key characters of living organisms are cellular organization, nutrition, respiration, metabolism, growth, response to stimuli, movement, reproduction, excretion, adaptation. You know very well that our body is made up of cells. It may be unicellular or multicellular. Nutrition. The feeding habit of organism is called nutrition. There are two types of nutrition: autotrophic nutrition, heterotrophic nutrition. The plants are in autotrophic nutrition because they can able to prepare their own food. The animals are in heterotrophic nutrition because they depend on other organisms for their food. Respiration. It is otherwise known as breathing. So during respiration, we inhale oxygen and exhale carbon dioxide. In our body, the respiratory organ or lungs. Growth. Increase in size is known as growth. Metabolism. The total chemical reaction which takes place in our body is called metabolism. There are two types of metabolism, anabolism and catabolism. The example for anabolism, the amino acids are combined together to form the protein. Catabolism is otherwise known as breaking down reaction. The food gets oxidized and release energy. Response to stimuli. Here in this slide, when one person touched the touch me not plant, immediately it respond. Immediately it started folding. So this is the best example for response to stimuli, children. Movement. Movement means that is moving from one place to another place. That is called movement. Reproduction. Giving birth to young ones or produce the young ones of same kind. Here I am showing one example. Hydra reproduces asexually by producing budding. Here on one side of the body tube, a small protrusion occurs. It enlarges in its size and gets detached from the mother hydra and lead an independent life. So it is the best example for asexual reproduction, which takes place in hydra. Sexual reproduction also there. For sexual reproduction, they need reproductive cells. Excretion. The sending out of waste products is called excretion. In our body, the excretory organ is kidney. Adaptation. Adaptation. Here, I show one example. The camel is well adapted to live in desert region. It can able to withstand the temperature till 42 degrees centigrade. And it has the hump on the backside to store fat. And it has thick eyebrows, long eyelash to protect the eyes from storm, sandstorm. So these are the adaptation found in camel. And if you see the fish, by using the fins, they can able to swim in water. By using the gills, they can able to breathe inside the water, because with the help of the gills only, it can breathe the dissolved oxygen from the water. It takes the dissolved oxygen from the water. Children, now I am going to explain about classification. Classification is a process by which things are grouped in convenient categories based on easily observable characters. Actually, the scientists analyze the animals by morphologically, anatomically, physiologically. According to their similarities and dissimilarities, they classify the animals. For example, you already studied about mammals and birds or apes. You should know how to differentiate a bird from the bat. The bird can able to fly with the help of feathers. That is the specific characteristic feature of birds. In bats, only the skin only stretched from forelimbs to hind limbs, and it gives birth to young ones directly. It feeds the young one with milk. These are the specific characteristic feature of mammal. So you should know how to differentiate the birds from bats. So for that we need classification. Basic need for classification: to identify and differentiate closely related species. For example, if you see the cat, tiger, cheetah, so they are, according to you, they are cat family, but externally they show some difference, not only externally, in feeding habit also. So you should know the variation among the species also. Variation means difference. So you can easily compare the compare one species with another species. To understand the evolution of the species, evolution means the new species is formed from pre-existing one. That is called evolution. To create a phylogenetic tree among the different groups according to the genetic arrangement, we can classify the organism. To conveniently study living organism, due to this classification, we can study about many living organisms. So children, in this video, I have completed these topics. You go through the topics. If you have any doubt, you ask me during live class. Thank you, children.